Now we shall learn the fundamentals of LINQ queries. First of all, you would want to know why LINQ queries. So why LINQ? This is what I have to say. An experienced developer of MVC, he begins to realize that LINQ is something that has a very close relationship with MVC. It is as if MVC is a lot simplified if one has a knowledge of LINQ. So it looks as if MVC is written keeping in mind the existence of LINQ. So you can do most of the things with ADO.NET, with the traditional ADO.NET, SQL data reader, data set. No doubt they'll be available to you, but they involve a lot of junk code. So if we can avoid that junk code and have an already available framework in LINQ that can do queries for you in a more standard way, structured way, then why not go for LINQ? It will simplify not only your combination to MVC, not only your communication with MVC, but also it will simplify the number of lines of code you write. And LINQ is very readable. So it comes naturally to a C# developer. It is available in Visual Basic also, so that is not our objective in this training course. So let us now begin to understand the fundamentals of LINQ. We'll start from the very, very basics so that the concept clarity is there, and that over a period of time you are able to build upon that knowledge to do even more complicated things. Let us start. What can be done with LINQ? One, you can do the equivalent of select query. Select a certain number of records matching a criterion or criteria. Number two, you can update, delete, and insert new records. This is also possible with LINQ. And if the built-in LINQ queries are not sufficient for something, or you find them too complicated, then in certain cases you can cause a direct query to SQL also. Query in SQL. You can write your own direct query and execute it against database, just like you would have done with traditional ADO.NET. We'll learn this later. In the coming days, we'll begin to learn this, so that through this we are able to master the fundamentals of LINQ. At no point in your understanding or working with LINQ will you ever feel that something is not present here. Generally, it does happen to us when we are learning a new technology and we all of a sudden look for something which existed in our previous technology, and we look for equivalents in this. And many times it does happen that the new technology does not have any equivalent, and then that makes us sad. But in LINQ, going through these three steps as you learn through this course, you will see that it is guaranteed that in learning the LINQ, you will never feel any disability vis-a-vis ADO.NET. This means if you plan to start a project with LINQ, then at no point will you ever be faced with a situation where you will say, "Oh, I should have started it in ADO.NET. That thing is not available here." So LINQ is such a powerful tool. So in our initial lectures, we will worry about the select. Okay, let us start. So now there are certain things that we will remember when we do LINQ query. When I mean LINQ query, it means select statement against the database. It means it operates, LINQ is going to operate against a database, data source, which effectively translates to a collection. For example, an string array. This is a collection. So LINQ operates on this. If you have this templated list class, this is also a collection. This is a fixed size collection. This is a variable size collection. You can add more elements or delete more elements out of this, but you cannot do this in a fixed size array. LINQ operates on this also and this also. LINQ operates on anything that can be put into a collection. For example, you have a database table, then database table can be viewed as a collection of records. Since a table can be modeled to be a collection of records, LINQ operates equally well on a database table also. So, as a first step, you should always catch hold of the collection. We must have the collection ready over which LINQ will execute. Second thing, write the query. And third, execute it. Writing a query, you will put conditions where order by. Writing a query is writing a specification. Writing conditions or writing something that acts on that collection. Execution is the actual command that is sent to the database or the collection. Writing and executing are two different things in LINQ. Writing is one thing and execution is something else. So throughout my lectures on LINQ, I'll continue to tell you the differences between these. If you are unable to understand these differences, then you might end up using LINQ ineffectively. LINQ will not run in an optimized manner. So to write a good and optimized code with LINQ, you have to be aware of this difference. So you will throughout continue to see these three things going on. I will always tell you, this is where we are getting the collection, here we are writing the query, and here we are executing it. So we shall now give you our first example of today, the simplest of all examples. What will our example look like? I will suppose these are brackets of a function. We'll see it shortly. So this is some function where we are writing this code. We'll start with a string array. A string array, ar is equal to, we can write here hoven, here we can write here java, here we can write mbc. So this line is doing what? It is giving you a collection. This line is giving you the collection. First thing. In the second case, we will execute a query against this. We'll define a query against this. So how do we define that query? We can define a query like this, where is a C# keyword that allows us to write one where we equal to this, whatever is the data type of the right side, compiler will automatically put it here. So we actually need not worry about what is the data type of right side. Compiler will look it for us and will replace this where automatically. There is no performance penalty of using where here. I could have equally written where ar is equal to this, because compiler understands that the right side is a string and it will automatically replace this where by this. So I have to obtain my query inside a variable, and I'm writing where v is equal to arr. I'm executing the query against this. So I'll define arr dot. It is a function like syntax that is available to us. We will write dot where. This is the condition. Condition has been written in the form of a lambda expression. This is called a lambda, and I'll explain when I go to the code. So for the moment you can take it that this means return all the elements from this array whose length exceeds 3. So this one won't come, this is this, and this will come. Remember, this is query definition and not execution. Now if we were to execute this query, then we will use something like a for each loop. So the moment you use a for each loop, this query is automatically executed. So first thing you can remember, when is it executed? It is executed when a for each loop is encountered. It is executed in other situations also. We learn all of them, but at least in for each, the moment a for each is encountered, this query gets executed. Let us now come over to our C# code and write this code and try to understand it further. So this is the code where we'll start. So you should have actually already created a basic MVC application. In the controllers, you should already have added home controller and changed the action result to string to return a hello world. I'll remove this one also. So this is up to where you should have already reached. Now let us begin to add a function. We'll call that later, folding it there. So we can write public string get data. So we have written a function called get data that will return some string for us, and we'll later on display that string on the screen. So first of all, let us create a string arr is equal to, so I'll write open comma java comma php. So I have got my collection here. Today we are writing a very simple collection. Tomorrow this collection will start coming from database. To illustrate the concept, we are starting with a simple collection. Okay. Next I am writing where query is equal to arr dot where angle bracket string x goes to x dot length is more than 3. So let us try to understand what has happened in this line. This is one method of link, or one technique of link. There is another technique also, where it uses from, you must have seen it in certain, from this, select this, which is more like SQL, but written in C#. That is an older way of doing this thing. So we will talk about that at a later stage, but our primary focus shall continue on this method, which was added later and now is the recommended way. This is called the method based query syntax. Method means a function. So this is a pure function like call. We shall be totally following this, because this one was an ad hoc introduction when Visual Studio was being released for LINQ. This was later superseded by this one. So you shouldn't be using this much. Use this one. So this I would say is older and this one is newer. Okay, having said that, we are writing arr dot, so dot means it is acting on arr dot where angle bracket. I am writing where. With each function, I'll write a templated version here. This string represents the type of collection. What is the type of collection? It is, the type of collection is string. From here we know So I will always write where angle bracket string, and then I am writing a condition. Here I could have written x, y, z. This is called goes to. This is called goes to. We will spell it goes to. This is a lambda. Lambda is a sort of a function written inside these brackets. So we are writing a function that takes an argument parameter called z, just like we would say fx string z. So you can just assume that it is sort of a bool. It returns a boolean true or false, and it gets a parameter of type z. Its type is deducible by the compiler because we are acting on a string collection and it is a string. It says select all elements for which z represents a variable for an element. Where z goes to, so you can say that this curly bracket is goes to. Where z goes to, the condition is z dot length more than 3. So all element, this is called a lambda expression. So all elements for which length exceeds 3 will find place in the query result. So if this collection had been a collection of int, then we would have written dot where angle bracket int, and condition could have been maybe we could have written y goes to y percent 2 is double equal to 0. So I mean this would have selected all the even numbers divisible by 2. So we can write any condition into this, so where this condition is met. Next, now let us now execute the query. For execution, since we are to store the results in a string, we can create a string builder. SB is equal to new string builder. String builder is a class that helps us to write long strings. It is optimized. So its usage you will come to know in a moment. Right click and resolve using system.txt. So you will have to add a namespace at the top. So if you see this one, system.txt has been added at the top. Okay, this is the string builder that we have created so that we can keep appending to it. For each, now what will this query contain? This query is going to contain strings. A smaller subset of this will be string collection. So we write for each string s in query. For each string s in query, we can write sb dot append, and we can write and this is hr tag of HTML. We can write append format s. So this will say if the first string is hoven, then it will push here hoven hr. Hr is a horizontal rule of HTML, hr tag, so that when it is displayed on the screen, it will display a line, horizontal line, and this will be formatted it as HTML. So since we have to send it as an HTML, so we can format it as we like. So S will find its way here and it will become Hovan HR. Then next time it will become Java HR. So for each candidate in this for each will be executed. So once this execution is complete, we can write return. So we'll get a string out of it, to string. So this is the function that we have written to return a long string. This one is optimized for creating a long string, because how long we'll never know, maybe 100 records. So this is optimized for appending. So we'll write for each string S in query append format, it will run and create a long string for us. And then we are writing sb.toString, so whatever is the combined string will be returned. Okay, here it is. Now let us call that function here. So when you call that function here, whatever is the process here, that will return you the string here, and we can display it on the screen. So let us execute it, and this is the result. Both these are having length longer than 3. So you have done your first link query today, and I would like to give you some exercise so that you become more confident in this. First, create an array of 5 int and using link display only even ones. Second, similarly create an array of 5 names of planets and display all which start with capital S. So 5 names of planets and display all which start with S. So how do you test for S? So if I have a string S and I want to check whether it, suppose this is Saturn, I want to check whether this starts with S, I can write S dot starts with is a function that you will find there, and you can write capital S there. So you should solve both of them, and this will make you become comfortable with the link. Thanks.